7 years ago, I was also a person who didn't have God in my life. 7 years ago, I was living without God. I had a belief of God. I had a belief of Jesus. I was brought up as a Catholic in the Catholic Church. I was forced to go to church by my mum and dad. I'd even pretend to go to church, go into church, take the slip of paper, and go off with my mates. Because church was religion. And I didn't believe in religion at the time. So I'm here to tell you this morning, if that's you, you have questions in your heart or in your mind. Everybody has those questions. There's guys up here who's willing to come and talk to you about those questions, openly. We're not here to condemn anybody, not here with religion. We're just here to talk about God. We're here to talk about Jesus Christ. We just want to talk to you this morning. If you have any need this morning, maybe you have difficulties in your life at the moment, maybe you've got illness, we're willing in faith to pray with you this morning and believe for healing this morning. The Bible says that God's a loving God. The Bible says that God loves you and me. The God of the universe loves you and me. How amazing is that? And even if you don't believe in Him, if you don't turn to Him, if you're not speaking to Him, the Bible still says He loves you. The Bible says that if you come before Him, Jesus said it like this. He said, if you have faith the size of a mustard seed, you can tell a mountain to move and it will obey you. I'm not talking about a literal mountain. Be a mountain in your life. Maybe you're experiencing something in your life. Maybe it's relationship. Maybe you're having difficulty in your relationship. Maybe you've got an illness and the doctors have given you a bad report. Maybe people have come against you and said you're useless and you're worthless and spoke death into your life. But we're here to tell you, for those people, their opinions don't count. They don't identify who you are. Unfortunately, we live in a society that's very judgmental. We judge people very quickly. I used to be one of them people. But that doesn't matter. What matters is God created you. The Bible says that God knew you before you were born. You have to try and get your head around that. That means before you were born, you were known by God. That means you are a spirit. That means you're made up of three things. Your body, your soul, and your spirit. And unfortunately in the world we have that the wrong way around. And we're governed by our soul and our feelings. And we don't have any government by our spirit. The Bible says the reason for that is your spirit is dead. The Bible says that the spirit between you and God is dead. So therefore you're governed by your feelings. You're governed by your gut. And we make decisions based on that. If I know that there's people walking by here now experiencing an emptiness in their heart, how do I know that? Because I was one of them, so.
Jesus is not real!
Amen. I was one of them people. I had an emptiness in my heart. And I tried to fill that with gambling. Other people try and fill it with drugs, alcohol, sex. Unfortunately, when the desire's met, that emptiness is still there. But I'm here to tell you, you can have that filled today, but it takes belief and it takes faith. And God will come into your heart and fill that. What people know about Jesus is what they've been taught. Most people don't even read the Bible today. Most people don't even give it the time. Most people look at their phones and spend hours on